Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Dr. Basili, a full-time orthopedic surgeon and national level faculty of orthopedics and a part-time YouTuber. In this video, I will share a technique which will make you focus like a machine and help you complete your daily targets like a boss. I will talk about the two biggest challenges of the students. One, starting to study for an exam, and number two, maintaining focus during study time. I'll give you one technique to solve both the problems. So let's get on with it. Okay, so how do you focus and study like a machine? The real question is, how do machines get more done compared to human beings? How are they faster and more efficient compared to any average person? How can they start without resistance and continuously do their task and then turn off when not needed? Why don't they get bored or distracted? The simple reason that comes to my mind is probably because they lack emotions and feelings. They don't get distracted by them. They were invented to do one task at a time and lack imagination to go on mental adventures like most of us, especially when we are doing something important like studying. Here I have a story for you. Tell me in the comments if you can relate to it. Say you have a big exam coming up in a month. Say the mid-year exam, final exam, whatever. Let's assume you have to read anatomy. You go out, get the book and sit down to read. You look at the previous questions and you realize there are so many. It has so many topics, so many nerves, so many arteries and bones. The skull itself has so many openings and each opening has so many structures. You are overwhelmed by the sheer volume of the subject. Why? Because you not only have to read it, but try to understand it, memorize it and hopefully reproduce it on the exam. And your subconscious starts to tell you, beta, ye to apne se nahi hoga, time hi nahi hai. So in self-defense, you keep postponing it by making unnecessary excuses. Aaj I am very busy. It's very hot today. I don't feel very well today. Or aaj phoopi ki beti ki dost ki shaadi mein jana hai. And you never start. Now suppose you mustered the courage to start. Picked a book, found a good spot in the corner of your library, opened the first page and start reading. You find it not so hard and immediately start thinking, what if I had started a few weeks ago? Yaar, ho jata tha yaar. Since it's not that hard, should I have read a bigger or better book? What if this book is not good enough to get good grades? What is everyone else reading? What if I top? What if I don't top? And you start thinking of so many possibilities and each possibility is more dramatic than the other. And in a matter of few minutes, you go from all happy and excited to read to sad and anxious about the results. And you have wasted a good 45 minutes. Now you feel disgusted with yourself and in self-defense, you tell yourself it's okay, you will start again tomorrow. And the story repeats itself. Does this story sound familiar? Exactly. Most of us have gone through it in our lives, whether it is in school, medical college, or even work. So here we have two problems. One is the internal resistance to start, and the other is the maintenance of focus while studying. Now these are the problems machines don't have. They don't get distracted from their task at hand, and that's why they get things done. So how can we get closer to their performance? Well, honestly, we can't. We are humans and we have emotions and distractions, so we can't do it for 24/7 like machines or computers, but we can definitely do it in small bursts. Human beings have an amazing ability to concentrate for short spans of time. And if we utilize these small bursts of focus, trust me, we can get a lot of things done. This is where this technique comes in. It's called the Pomodoro technique. I'm sure most of you must have heard about it or even used it. But in case you haven't, I will share how I use this technique with you and tell you how you can improve it. I will also suggest some tools and apps to help you get started. I've been using this technique since a long time now and it has helped me overcome the internal resistance to start, avoid distractions, stay focused and most importantly, accurately assess how much work I can get done. The theory behind the Pomodoro technique is that any large task can be broken down into short timed intervals called Pomodoros, and each Pomodoro is separated by a short break. This takes advantage of our brain's short attention spans. You focus only on the task at hand for that time period and then take a small break. And you keep doing this for a few cycles, after which you take a longer break. So what are the things you need to get started? The first thing is a timer. You can use an old school timer or you can also use a timer app. My personal favorite is Tide. It's free and provides customization of your intervals based on your capacity and also provides ambient sound to help you stay relaxed and focused. It also has an immersive mode, which basically means that if you exit the app during a study session, it will fail that session, preventing you from using your phone while studying. The second important thing is selecting a task. You have to select one and only one task to do in a particular Pomodoro. You can use multiple Pomodoros for a single task, but you should not do multiple tasks in one Pomodoro. One task matlab one particular topic, say Coley's fracture from ortho or vitamins from biochemistry. Now set the timer to 25 minutes and start doing that topic. Focus only on doing that topic, nothing else. Block everything out. No talking, no smiling, no staring, absolutely nothing. Avoid constantly checking the timer also. Just keep focusing and working. Tell yourself it's only for 25 minutes na. Till then, just keep working. When the timer goes off, get up, take a small 5 minutes break. Not at the same place, go out, go get water, coffee or whatever. Repeat for 4 Pomodoro cycles and then take a longer break of say 15 to 20 minutes. Keep on repeating the whole thing again throughout your day. Now the things to consider are distractions. The technique will not work if you're getting distracted. The whole point of this technique is to have an intense focus for 25 minutes. If you keep checking Facebook, WhatsApp, Insta or my YouTube page, you will not be using the technique properly. So avoid all kinds of distractions. Keep the phone on airplane mode or use a basic phone with a timer. If someone comes along to talk, do what I do. Inform them that you're reading or working for the next 25 minutes. And if it isn't a matter of life and death, tell them that you will get back to them in the break. Most reasonable people will understand. Try to make the maximum of those 25 minutes. Now, when do I use this technique? When I started using Pomodoro, it was for getting over the initial resistance or when I lacked motivation for starting a dull or boring topic. So I would just trick myself by saying it's only for 25 minutes na, I will do it. And since it was a very small commitment, my brain wasn't afraid of the task. And as I repeated it a few times, the whole task wasn't an issue because I already gained the momentum to complete it. I also use it for any task that I don't have time for. For example, I reserve 1 or 2 Pomodoro slots to answer my students' queries every few days. Now, what are the modifications you can do? You don't have to stick to the 25-minute interval. You can increase it according to your liking. Sometimes when I'm in a flow, I have 50-minute slots just a few days before the exam. So customize it according to your liking. Although I have noticed that if you try to focus for more than an hour, it is usually less efficient and you tend to drag. So find your optimal window of focus. And once you get the hang of it, you can make your own intervals, say after finishing a certain topic or set number of pages or doing a few modules of Marrow. So for me, if I have the momentum, I use the 55 minutes and 10 minute routine. And if I don't, I use the 30 minute, 10 minute routine. So how does Pomodoro work? How does it help you overcome the initial mental resistance and sustain your focus through the study time? See, most of us lack self-discipline, including me. This technique simply externalizes the discipline aspect of how long you should be reading by using a timer. Humans have a tendency to act consistently with their decision if their drive is concrete, like writing down or using a timer. It also allows you to get over the mental resistance of starting things by easily convincing yourself that whatever it is, it's going to end in 25 minutes. See, this is an input-based behavior compared to the conventional output-based behavior that we are used to, where the end is when you finish a chapter or a subject and you have no idea how long it will take. Here, you do whatever you have to do for 25 minutes only, so you're not intimidated by the volume of the task at hand. So what are the take-home points? First, identify the topic or subject you have to read. Collect all the things you would need when you're reading, like notes, pen, water, etc. Hide yourself away from all kinds of distractions. Put the phone on airplane mode, start the timer and get cracking. Keep on chugging those Pomodoros and in no time, you will notice that you have gotten so much more work done. If you manage to even do only 10 Pomodoros in the beginning, it's almost 4.5 hours of super focused reading in a day. It's amazing, isn't it? So what are you waiting for? Start. So do you have any other productivity technique that you use to stay on track? I love to hear from you. Share your experiences with me in the comment box below. I would love to chat down there with you guys. If I've helped you in any way, click the thumbs up button and share this video with a friend who's struggling to read efficiently for exams. If you have not already subscribed, consider subscribing to the channel, and don't forget to click the bell icon if you want to be notified when I upload my videos. So I guess I will see you in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.